Hello friends, welcome to our new episode, and we're back with some latest space updates for you. First, we'll start with a Starship update as SpaceX reinstalls engines on SN20. Then we'll talk about tank tracks from Germany. Then we'll have a look at China's Mars-bound drone, and finally we'll wrap up with an FAA pause on Virgin Galactic launches. So let's begin today's space updates with SpaceX reinstalling three Raptor engines on SN20. We've seen SpaceX teams reinstall the Raptor engines on the Super Heavy booster BN-4 after a few days from the removal of the Raptor engines from it. SpaceX is going through the same path with Starship SN20 also. Similarly, like the BN-4 booster, Raptor engines of SN20 have been removed. SpaceX teams had nearly finished installation and repairs of TPS heat shield tiles, and they recently moved on for reinstallation of three of the six Raptor engines on Starship SN20. As stated earlier, SpaceX had reached the epic event of fully stacking Starship and Super Heavy a month ago on the 6th of August. Following that fit check event, both the Starship SN20 and Booster 4 had been separated and moved back to the factory. SpaceX engineers had removed all the engines of SN20 and sent it to the suborbital Pad B after nearly a week. As per reports, SN20 had been installed in Pad B since the 13th of August. This step was intended to carry out cryo tests, as Pad B had been modified by SpaceX for such tests. But no tests of that sort had happened. Moreover, the modifications had been removed from the pad. Normally, rockets carry out their cryo tests and pressure with hydraulic thrust simulators and then move on for static fires, especially in the case of Starship. But SpaceX is always known for doing something different. So they started reinstallation of three Raptor engines on the giant steel prototype. Instead of doing tests, they focused on repairing damaged heat shield tiles and installation of remaining ones. They've also worked upon numerous steel tubes, tanks, and other equipment, and made the rocket more flight-worthy. Those three Raptor engines were rolled by SpaceX on the 5th of September. And by the 6th of September, they got the Raptors installed inside Starship SN20. As things are going different in testing procedure, it's quite difficult to find out how SpaceX is drawing the future of Starship SN20. As three Raptors are already installed, this is quite plausible that the vehicle will first carry out the ambient pressure and cryogenic proof tests with Raptor engines recently installed. The vacuum-optimized Raptors are also expected to be installed within the upcoming days. Regarding the heat shield installation, SpaceX engineers have completed almost 95% of the overall area to be installed with tiles. Some reports say they've used more than 15,000 tiles to cover the side of Starship SN20, which will face atmospheric heat during re-entry. Earlier, they had the experience of installing fewer than 500 to 1,000 TPS tiles, but this time we can say another epic work. The most critical part of covering the aft fins and its bends with heat shield have been successfully carried out with custom-built TPS tiles. Other than these, plumbing, avionics, and tank parts of SN20 are also nearly finished. We can hope for any testing on SN20 within upcoming weeks. Now we'll discuss our next update about SpaceX and its new tank tracks ordered from cranes from German manufacturer Leffler. A recent tweet from a user named Max has thrown some light on SpaceX's probable new ideas of placing a grand order to German manufacturer Leffler. Max has captured some tank tracks which had the SpaceX logo on them. The tank tracks were on the A2 Autobahn in Germany, and the vehicle carrying the tanks was coming from Austria. Along with the information, Max also assumed a probable use of the tracks and also their destination. Twitter users went on guessing the possible usage of the tracks. Some even suggested that these tracks will probably be used as an upgrade to the Cybertruck. Chris Bergen then stepped into the matter, putting a pause on the guessing game, and said that the tracks are purchased by SpaceX and belong to a crawler crane for the company. The company already uses cranes from Leffler. These cranes are used in Texas's Boca Chica facility. Reports suggest that the crane in use, i.e. the Blue Zilla, is being rented out by SpaceX. Moreover, Elon Musk's tweet, "Our new crane," was a foreshadowing about the company's new purchase. It's quite possible that the order was placed in March. Netizens now are guessing the probable color of the crane. Black seems to be a potential color. We have to wait till everything is officially revealed. Our following update is about China's progressive steps to space with the development of their own Martian helicopter. After NASA's Ingenuity helicopter continued success on Mars, China is also following the same steps to put a drone on Mars and is thoroughly working on it. On the 20th of August 2020, the National Space Science Center under the Chinese Academy of Sciences had publicized that a prototype of Mars Surface Cruise Drone had passed the final approval assessment. The National Space Science Center had backed three projects in a technological development event. This drone project was one of them, and it's headed by Bianxiang Zhang of this center. NASA had propounded and succeeded in the theory of making a craft airborne on the Martian surface. Their concept faced success when the Perseverance rover of NASA landed on Mars with the Ingenuity helicopter in February 2021, and Ingenuity made its first flight by April 2021. After that, NASA's made regular successes in flight to another planet and flown the helicopter for the 12th time by the 16th of August. China has also focused on this subject since mid-2020. The Tianjin Laboratory of Space Technology had propounded such a concept for their 2020 Mars mission. In that proposal, they had planned for a rover which comprises three ground penetrators, one aerostat for aerial view analysis. Their plan was to get three-dimensional, multi-layer, and multi-source information from Martian land from a single mission. Now, regarding the present drone concept, they've planned for a winged drone. As per some reports, the helicopter-modeled rotorcraft was not taken as it has some drawbacks of requiring higher velocity of rotor blades, higher power efficiency, and need for lightweight material. Report says this Chinese Martian drone will be installed with a microspectrometer. The drone would lift off vertically from the surface of Mars before pitching and deploying its wings. The drone will have a range of nearly 10 kilometers, with potentiality of reaching such places where a rover can't go, and it can be capable of gathering land and atmospheric samples. If they can further improve it, then the drone will be capable of analyzing the collected samples. China's upcoming Mars mission is the sample return mission, scheduled to launch either on a launch window of 2028 or 2030. Let's have a look at an update regarding the FAA pausing launches of Virgin Galactic on ground of Unity 22 flight problem. Richard Branson had successfully reached the edge of space, but on the 2nd of September, the Federal Aviation Administration stated that a problem had occurred in the Unity 22 flight of the 11th of July. Though it appeared normal, an investigation of this mishap should not be neglected. The agency had further stated, Virgin Galactic may not return the Spaceship 2 vehicle to flight until the FAA approves the final mishap investigation report or determines the issue related to the mishap does not affect public safety. The agency stated this when a report came forth in an article that Spaceship 2 pilots of the Unity 22 mission had ignored an entry glide cone warning and continued the flight. That article stated that such warning should call for an abort, but pilots David McKay and Mike Masucci let the motor fire for the full duration. It flew for some more time than scheduled airspace and landed safely. The company said this flight tracking data disputed the misleading characterizations and conclusions. Virgin Galactic accepted that the vehicle did drop below the altitude of the airspace that's protected for Virgin Galactic missions for a short distance in time. The company stated that high winds at upper altitudes caused abnormality in trajectory, which ultimately triggered the warning. Our pilots responded appropriately to these changing flight conditions, exactly as they were trained and in strict accordance with our established procedures. Although the flight's ultimate trajectory deviated from our initial plan, it was a controlled and intentional flight path that allowed Unity 22 to successfully reach space and land safely at our spaceport in New Mexico, said Virgin Galactic. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.